Karen.
Sound, speed, background action.
Karen.
Action. I did that on purpose. Okay. Action.
Karen Marilla.
Carly Anderson. Okay, so a lot of kids ask for puppies, that sort of thing. I'm a crazy cat lady, I accept it. Sadly, there's only one in my life. Go back a few years, there were a few more, but you know, it wasn't my house, it was my parents'. So for Christmas, every year, I would ask for a small, white female kitten. That's all I wanted. Which is weird, because I'm a Sailor Moon fan, and she had a black cat. I don't understand that. But I wanted a small, white female kitten every year, top of my list. Never happened. Also never got the TV, but I forgave that. So one year for Christmas, I come downstairs, regular Christmas. I say regular, Christmas is always fantastic, so why would I say that? Open the presents, tons of great ones. I'm a slow present opener. I like to savor every single present. I will take the entire day. Still, because we're a big present family. I'm opening every single one, I'm enjoying every single one. And my parents are looking a little antsy at this point. Like, okay. And I'm in to the side, I've noticed that there's some wrapping paper near the wall, which I've assumed that I've thrown there because I'm not exactly ladylike when it comes to wrapping paper. So at some point they go, Carly, what's that over there? You haven't opened that one. I'm like, what? Okay. So I go over and I pull the wrapping paper away. And it's this crate. And I look inside. And like these two tiny, adorable yellow eyes look back at me. Oh my God. Oh my God. And it's dark. So I open the crate. And this tiny little black cat comes out. At this point, it hasn't really occurred to me the irony of the situation. I'm just like, cat, cat, yes, oh my God. Little 8-year-old me is ecstatic. So I'm playing with this cat. I'm like, oh my God, I need to name her. Her name's gonna be, it has to be something cliche. It has to be either like Fluffy or Princess. And they're like, I think it's a boy. And I'm like, Prince. And they're like, that's a dog's name. And I'm like, Prince. This cat took to that name amazingly. And he was like my kitty soulmate. I loved him to death. He was precious and perfect. And he knew that he was a prince. I literally at one point tried to carry him around on a pillow, and he was like, yes, this is wonderful. This is exactly what we should be doing every day for the rest of my natural born life. So I was also a Girl Scout, and we as the pet person, decided to have a pet badge, and I brought in a pet psychic. You can find those around here, which is great. So bring in the pet psychic. It was at my house, so my cat was right there. She starts talking to Prince. She's like, she goes, this cat's name is not Prince. And I was like, what? What are you talking about? The cat's name is Prince. We have an understanding here. She goes, the cat's name is Cece for carbon copy. And I was like, what? And I assume at this point she has seen a picture of my mom's black cat named Gypsy, and then she says, this is the reincarnation of Gypsy. I'm like, what? So of course, every single middle-aged woman watching this going, it's the cat, formerly named Prince. That's the story.
Great. Names, please.
Karen Marilla.
Carly Anderson.
So when I first moved to the U.S., I was 5 or 6, turning 7 or 5. I was 5 or 6, turning either 6 or 7, and I didn't speak English. English is not my first language. And I moved into my neighborhood in Northeast Philly, and I have no friends. So every day I would go out to my doorstep and I would take my Barbies with me and I would just sit there and play by myself. And that happened for maybe like not even 2 days, because I'm not saying back in the day, because I'm not, you know, I can't say back 50 years ago, but back 10, oh my God, 15 years ago. a little more than 15 years ago, everyone would go outside and play. Not like today where the streets are abandoned and no one plays double dutch or no one's biking or just playing tag. So there were always a lot of kids. And finally one day, this girl from across the street named Samaya came up to me with her Barbie dolls. And she started speaking in English and I'm speaking in Spanish. We have no idea what we're saying to each other, but we bonded over our dolls. And then, like, after that day, she would just come over and we would always play Barbies. And I don't know how, we didn't understand each other, obviously, but there was a connection with Barbie. Eventually, when I learned English within that, those few months, thanks to ESL classes, we were finally able to communicate and properly play Barbies for the next 5 years.
Names, please.
Kara Marillo.
Carly Anderson.
Changing chairs. Excuse me. And names again, please.
Carly Anderson.
Karen Marilla.
And Karen goes.
A few years ago, this time much more recent, like I'm going to say 3 years ago, I went with my friend from school to Colombia because my dad's side is from Colombia. And we decided to go on a backpacking trip around. Like, we hit maybe 4 different cities. And the last city we hit before having to fly back to the capital to then come back to the US and go to school the next day, we were backpacking through this national park. And the plan was, okay, we're gonna get there, we're gonna hike 3 hours, see the beach. Well, not 3 hours, I thought it was gonna be an hour or so. See the beach and play for, like, you know, go in the water, enjoy it for a little, and then come back. So that morning, I don't know why, but I wore flip-flops. Not a good idea. I wore flip-flops and, you know, just brought my phone and a towel. And some money to buy food. And so did my friend. And we're on, like, the little local bus on the way to the national park. And it was early in the morning, and I'm falling asleep, and, like, I keep on hitting this person, like, this guy who's, like, standing on the bus. And, like, finally, when I, like, woke up again, I was, like, apologize. And we started talking because he was meeting his friends. To stay the night in a tent. And I was like, oh, that's so cool. And we latched onto him to go through our adventure. And that's when we learned that the hike was actually 3 to 4 hours. And by the time we had gotten there, and we had gone through and finally reached, like, the ocean, it was... We had not even half an hour until the beach closed, and it would get dark. They said it would get dark soon, so we wouldn't have time to hike back. So we were kind of stuck there just with, like, our towel and money and phone that was now dying. And then the next day we had a flight to catch. And so we're like, okay, well, we can't go back. We're kind of stuck here. So thankfully, the guy that I had kept on hitting on the bus, he lent us his one-person tent, and he stayed the night. So we stayed the night, and then woke up at 5 in the morning. We realized there's no way we're going to make it back through this 3-4 hour hike. They were renting horses, so we took a horse back to the front of the park. From there, got in a taxi, went to our hostel, got our things, went to the airport, and got on the flight to go back to the capital city to finally come back to the U.S. for school the next day.
Names, please.
Karen Marilla.
Carly Anderson. Okay, so a lot of cousins in my family are grouped around the same age range. There was, like, cousins, the middle cousins, and the baby cousins who we can't even believe that they're technically like the same generation as us. They're not. We don't count them. They're babies. It doesn't matter that one is now 17. It doesn't count. I'm part of the middle generation. My Uncle Chris's children are older and middle. My Uncle Chris married my Aunt Sherry, and she already had two daughters, Brittany and Brianna. Brittany was 2 months younger than me. You would think that we would be best friends. Oh no. No, 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 we hated each other. We hated each other's guts. Like, literally, I think as a 5-year-old, I would have taken a knife to her. And then she would have broken out her own knife and we would have, like, battled. It would have been great. So we hated each other, and this was a long-standing thing. So, naturally, they decide to put us in a tiny room together while my Uncle Sean is getting married to my Aunt Jen. They're getting married. It's beautiful, and the children aren't there. Even more beautiful. I highly recommend that. Except not as 5-year-old Carly, who was stuck in that room with Brittany, because while this wedding is going on, beautiful ceremony, everyone's in the ugliest 90s dresses you will ever see, the wall started banging. They could, because there was glass, there was like a glass window that I think they could, it was, looked like a mirror, somewhat two-way mirror thing to make sure that they could watch the little children's, but they weren't, because the wedding was going on. And it started shaking and banging. And they're trying to ignore this because wedding. What we come to find out, we being they, is that that was me banging, banging, banging against the wall, screaming for help, because Brittany is attacking me and beating me up during this entire ceremony. I'm screaming, pleading for help, and no one has heard me. You would think that would be the end of it, but no.
And yet it must be. Okay. So, names one last time.
Karen Murillo.
Carly Anderson.
To be continued. Thank you.